Hello, let's have a look at the voltage supply of the Gigatron TTL microcomputer. If you've built your own Gigatron computer, you will have gotten with the kit a mini USB cable to power up the board. This cable does not supply data, it only supplies power to run the system. You can hook it up to a laptop computer or desktop computer to supply the voltage or to one of these power adapters that you can plug into the mains. I have two of those. Let's plug one in and hook up the computer. And what you see is that the power OK LED is now on. We also see the running lights here indicating that the board is actually working at this moment. So that's all fine. But let's suppose this is not our power adapter, but this is. Again, we hook up the board, but now we see that the power OK LED is flashing. This is an indication that this power supply is not outputting a voltage that's high enough to power the board. If this happens, try a different power supply or try a laptop computer. You can also try a power bank. You see that in this case, this power bank is also supplying enough power. We see the power LED LED on. I can actually show you using this cheap USB tester. If I hook it up to the white power supply that didn't work, it tells me it outputs 5.3 volts. If I connect it to the black one, that didn't work, it tells me it outputs less than 5 volts, which is not enough. In the meantime, this board has now shut off. Actually, the power bank has shut off. This is something that occurs a lot with power banks. Since the Gigatron is using only so little power, the power bank thinks nothing is connected and will shut off. So I can turn it on again, and we see that the power OK LED is on. But the best solution for this is to use the second output port on the power bank to connect a second USB device that will also draw power, making the power bank to stay on. So bottom line, if you see the blinking lights, everything is fine. If you see the power OK LED flashing, the problem is probably that your power supply is not outputting a voltage that's high enough to power the board, and the solution is to try different power supplies until you find one that will actually power on your board. Thank you for watching.